Operational report. Submarines detected. Repairs complete. Contact report. Kill credits. Contact report. Contact report. Contact report. Kill credit. Supplies moved. Expansions. Replacements taken. Oh, 441 attains carrier status. Great. Maybe we can switch it out with something else. I'll have to remember that. We'll try to remember that. LST arrives Portland. Reinforcements San Francisco and Cape Town. Ah. The planes arrive via rail. Hong Kong. K-16 is in. Oh, and we're going to set it for upgrade. Narwhal is repaired. Form up subtransport, Narwhal. Where to go, though? I think now, this one we can try for Rachiga. Other transport, Quinhon, just sitting here waiting. The core is almost out. It moved 23 in one turn. Hopefully it'll move another 23 next turn. Moving southwest. This one's moving to the east. 28, not too shabby. And we have our hammer coming down from Vin. Any other? Oh, we have more movement here. Another 67th Chinese Corps has arrived. I am liking. I think we're all heading for Crete. Where's the rest of my 67th Corps, though? Oh, there. One's at Hanoi. This is my garrison unit. Packed. Ready to leave. At Vin. Okay, these have all arrived. So the Lancer is going to launch them towards Paxe. Set all to march, and we're waiting around for the last one. Once this 67th has also arrived, we'll send it forward. Note the 67th is not my garrison unit. I'm using the cavalry as garrison. I've brought the 3rd Assam Rifles all the way across Burma to be garrisoned here. Can you believe that? Quiet over in Pakoi. Little air activity over in Amoy. I can't remember if they attacked. Here are the reinforcing fighters. We're down at fatigue level 4. We're not in a rush. Wait for it. Lido, here's my other reinforcing fighters, the Mohawks. We're at range of fatigue of 0, so now the time to transfer them back to Tuyun. Don't crash. Too damaged. Okay, damaged is not a crash. Chungking, quiet. The Warhawks have been scoring heavily. Look at those. Nice. Look at all those missions. Look at all that experience and kill count. Jeez, some of the best pilots around. They just have nothing to fly. They flying junk airplane. Well, not. These are okay. The 40 Echoes are okay, but we don't get any more. That's it. That's all we got. Well, no. Whoa, it's supposed to be here till 5:43, so we do get some. Oh, here are some replacements. My mistake. We've also got a few vanguards appearing. Oh, but the vanguards, this is it for them. 1242, that's all that's left. So same with the lancers. That's all that's left. Use them up as replacements. Manchuria. Good stuff. Lots of interesting thing happening here. We were bombed. Let's see. Did anybody? Yes, they dropped us into combat mode. Damn it. Disabled a couple. That's okay. We're going to march right back into those buggers. These guys are almost in fact, I'm going to set everybody in combat mode. Why? Hold on. Gosh. Which one did I just set back into combat mode? Anyone remember? Crud. She just got bombed. 86? I think it was... could have been this one. Nonetheless, we're going to put everybody in combat mode. Why? Because they're most of them are only 1 mile away. Putting them in combat mode makes them more... resilient. If they happen to get bombed, they'll be able to shrug it off more easily. The headquarters moves. These are also at 45, most of them. This one's not, so I'll leave it in movement mode. He's heading to the southwest. He's cutting across country. It's not on a road, so it makes it more difficult. So those headquarters taken care. The infantry, the artillery. See, also in 45. Just about to leap over into the last one. Right, the enemy blasted the hell out of this headquarters. Ouch! A shot to the head. Ow! These recover, with the supplies, they recover fairly decently. Fairly decently. So we're going to rest here. See if this guy pursues. We've got headquarters units here moving across. Should be able to cut off this next turn or the turn afterwards. Same thing, this one moving down. This one over here has moved in. Now, where do I go from here? See, you see the little red line here? The little red line means that we don't own the hex, but we could move in here to cut it off. If we move in here to cut it off, that means this one's open. So I don't think I can go anywhere. I think I have to stay right where I am in order to cut off supply in either direction. Here! Oh, baby! We moved in this. The headquarters has moved in. We've got a few headquarters and artillery cutting off the enemy. But most importantly, oh, yes! The 66th Chinese Corps is in! 2 days left on her life expectancy. Set everyone to a deliberate attack. But this one, oh, no. She's going to shock it. Use her big brawn and try to beat the living daylights out of that enemy unit. Too bad there's only 1 year. We were hoping for two. I checked the general. The general's not... he's got a land rating of 43. Whereas the highest rating is 69. So 43 isn't bad. Isn't bad. Should I try to buy him out and set him and replace him with a turd before he's relieved of command? I might. This would cost me 10 political points, but geez, do I have... I mean, he's not really a great general, but he's not really a bad general either. I think I might... it's not that I've been really worried about the command levels in China. We've been conquering the country, even with the crappy jet, with good or bad, we've been conquering the country. Okay, so these guys are attacking... This hex has already been sealed. So you notice the green here, and this line's been sealed, so we don't have to worry about that. I'm going to take the one that's resting. I'm going to move them back up here. In fact, I think I'm going to set both of them to move right here. The enemy has this hex side's already been sealed. I don't need to seal it again. The infantry moving up from this road has sealed it. Captured this hex side. That'll leave these guys. Well, yeah. Oh, I don't need to. I'm gonna. Well, one. This guy's gonna rest. I don't need both of them up there, I guess. So I'll rest one, move the other. Just to keep this area kind of surrounded, or surrounded on this side. Here, we've got another one. Two enemy units. Oh, this is... I think he's escaped up here and across. All right, I've got an infantry unit here. This one, I'm not going to do anything. I'm in the hex. I'm holding him. I think I'm holding him. This one's totally surrounded. Hey! This infantry unit came out of Fusin, captured this hex side. So you know it's green. But notice all the other hex sides are red. So the AI could escape through those hexes. But we've got him. We've got units all around him. So he is surrounded and cannot leave through one of the... Cannot, well, he can leave through one of those hexes. So we're going to use this one. We're heading to the southeast. No, we're going to... I'm going to change that. We're going to move this one straight to the southwest. We're going to move through this hex side in the northeast and cut it and then capture it. Same over here. We're going to move right into the enemy. This hex side is also... we check out this hex side. See, this one's already been won. One unit had come back through here. So this one, we own this hex side for this hex. So this headquarters unit is free to move. We're going to move it right down the road to seal off this enemy unit here. Same, this headquarters unit. Whoa, we got a lot of headquarters units here. I can move one of them to the northeast to try and trap this hex side. The unit in the hex has 500 assault value. The enemy's not going to push us out of here. Unlikely. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this hex, blast this one, and then move up the road and around and kill this one from behind, crush it while before moving down, if we can hold this one long enough before killing this one. So we're chasing these little cockroaches around the countryside. I have another headquarters unit here. This one's moving to the northeast. Oh, good stuff. So this one can move. If this one moves to the northeast, this one can move to the west. We can try to go down the road and seal in the enemy unit from the other side. The unit down here is probably going to be crushed this turn. We've got 5,200 attacking it. It will take me two days to move this one out of here. Yeah, at least 2 days to move out of here. So this one's going to die within this day or the next day. Either way, it dies. So I don't have to worry about the northwestern corner. Here, a little more concern. I can't move. If I try to move here, if I try to move into the hex, what happens is... It does work. I always thought that the AI would try to use the road hex, come down, force me to come down, and then move across. And that would mean I wouldn't be able to seal up that red line there, that red hex side. But the AI has plotted, has said it's going to the southeast. I'll have to check that. I'll have to make sure he doesn't all of a sudden just shift me to the southwest and then go to move eastward. Because that using the roads is sometimes faster than going directly. Moving to the east, we've got one base force coming out. Okay, it's going to take at least 2 turns, more like 4. Hopefully we can get here before this enemy can get out. These enemies here, we have a headquarters unit also in. I will move this headquarters unit. Where do I move this headquarters unit? I will try to move it up the road. So that, see that? Now it's going to go to the west and then upwards, because this hex site is not owned by me. This one up here, moving to the southeast to trap. And we've built up a base at Fusin, at Qinqiao. I'm thinking about moving my base forces up. We're getting bombed at Mukden. Due to insufficient air cover. Oh boy. I'm not sure what I can do. Or do I just keep taking the bombing? Well, if I stay here, at least I can provide coverage when we march on Port Arthur. Maybe I'll just have to suck it up. Just take the bombing. Siam, we've taken Mergui, and the enemy's cost me he not heavily, but enough. Annoying, you bugger. Okay, we're gonna deliberate attack with everybody. We're just the fatigue is okay. The tanks were disruption at 20. That's just at the level I'm going to accept before putting him into recovery. So 1700. Let's kill this thing. The other units are starting to move out already. Good. Still starving. See, nothing. Zero. Zilch. Bupkis. Heading past the headquarters, is heading down to Nakhon Sitamarat. Chumpon, starving to death as well. These guys are all trying to move out of here. Same over at Suratani. The army's arrived pretty much here. Now we're going to keep marching them out. Disembarking and marching them out. We have three anti-aircraft. Is it three or four? Four. And I'm making sure these guys are marching out at combat mode so that they can continue to fire. Even though it's slower marching, but they're able to respond to air threats. But we have no air cover. Supply zero. Bangkok's still sucking wind, but 18 is not zero. So I don't know what to do. They're flying, at least flying. Ayutthaya has 400 supplies, so it's got some coverage of the area. Moomin, empty. We just have a garrison unit here. And we continue to push them through to Chiang Mai to get them on the railroad. We have some pretty large air fleets just sitting here waiting to help. Here's my bow fighters. You know, these guys are. I think I'm going to send them to China. These guys have such wonderful range for night for coverage. Let's see, how far can we go? Can we get over to Sin? We could even get over to Sin Kang. Sin Kang and Amoy. Okay, Amoy has he's a little bit overloaded right now. Let's get him over to Canton, let him rest, and then switch him over to Sin Kang. Here we go, Canton. Resting. One damage. No. One damage on landing. Okay. We have another bullfighter group. Where are they? Ah, here they are. We've been waiting. Okay, we need another 4 days before we pull them from the replacement pool. 943, so they're still in production. I want to get them maximized. These have, look at that range. 13, or sorry, 11, normal radius, 11. That's just a massive range we can use for night patrols. Covers a huge area. I'll probably save one for down here because we have such few airfields that can be used that I'll put one here, and then we can fly for a large area around protecting. That way I won't need a night fighter protection on each and every base. Hopefully that's how it will work. Submarine detected in the Bay of Bengal. Damn it. That looked the stupid thing. Ah, he's actually in shallow water. Generally, the AI tries to stay out of the shallow water. So this one ventures in. This could be interesting. He might be coming after my transports that are hugging the coast. That would not be a good thing because we're keeping Akyab viable. Well, not viable. It's got 400,000, and I'm amazed that Chittagong only has 36. I don't know, where the hell is it going? We're connected by rail. We've got 4 million supplies on the subcontinent, and we can't get more than 30,000 into Chittagong? Are you kidding me? Oh, man. Another unit coming into Impal. Impal has 3 units marching south. Set for Singapore. Great. And any submarines? No submarines ready at Calcutta. Well, we keep hunting the enemy submarine around here. Maybe he's already gone past. Maybe he's heading over to Bombay. We haven't seen anything. Darn it. Okay, my destroyer escorts are going to be leaving within the week. Convoy coming in under escort. Convoy at the switchover point. No reinforcements in Aden. No new reinforcements in Cape Town, South Africa, or Mombasa. In Mombasa, no, there's no need. These are all refueled, just waiting for the arrival of those anti-aircraft guns. Checking over in East... No, nothing happening in East Africa. East Africa. Eastern United States, doing a submarine check. The SSTs. Oh, yes, we know about these. Heading in to capture... Heading out. Just waiting. Let's see, any other ships in major damage? Swordfish. Whoa, hold on, did I miss this one? How did I miss this one, huh? Swordfish requires upgrade as well, so we'll disband. Yeah, sloppy me again. Shipyard. I'm going to give it a critical. This one, yeah, still a critical because this is regular damage, not refitting. Grouper, why the low fuel? Interesting, it didn't refuel on the way in. Sea Raven, okay, both of them. We're sending them back out, one for Chiba, one for Shikoku Station. Ah, damn it, the submarine is not playing with us near Ceylon. So we're just hunting empty ocean here. Convoy, regular convoy going out, coming in under escort. Nothing happening. We're at the handover point, changeover point. So convoy coming in. We're going to switch out escorts, and the other one's going home. Hopefully, we're one hex short. Maybe we'll be okay, avoiding those submarines or that submarine around here. More convoys coming. Abaddon in and out. Nothing, no reinforcements at Aden. No reinforcements at Cape Town or Mombasa. Units have not arrived in Eastern yet. The enemy, I think, has retaken Larantoka. I don't know. If he just keeps taking them, I'll just keep grabbing them back. That's fine. We're just wasting time on these. The enemy did attack, I believe, Darwin. We intercepted. Did we get any kills? Oh, lots of good experience. Lots and lots of good experience character building. I would call it character building. We've detected no units. E-boats, are they reinforcing or are they evacuating? I don't know. Quiet on Hollandia. I think there was an attack. Well, there may or may not have been one. I can't remember. Just too many things happening. Building character. We have a Navy squadron up here, building character. It's only got 2 fighters. I wonder if I should upgrade these things. Yeah, with only 2 fighters, you can only fly so many patrols a day. So I might have to upgrade it just so that they have more planes in the air. Let's see, do we have any old fighters to use? Well, I guess we could use the 33 Alphas or the Buffaloes. I'll consider that. I'll check it out. Keep in mind. Nothing happening on the Gold Coast, I guess that is. Convoy or the AK heading up to Townsville. all the land units heading out to Townsville as well. Convoys coming in past the Solomon's Chain. Quiet at Suva. Quiet in the Panama. Quiet in Pearl Harbor. San Francisco. I've got this is the LS, the landing ship I'm sending over to Panape to help with the amphibious efforts. I've got another transport group. I'm sending this transport group to Wake. And then doing the same thing as the previous transport group, meeting up at Wake and then trying to head into Guam directly. Problem is, look at this. There's a tanker here and two tankers in this one. And hey, I'm dumb, but I'm not stupid. Okay, I'm stupid too. But I still remember all the problems we had trying to unload at Panape. And that was when the port was actually functional, fully functional, and we couldn't get the stuff off. It just jammed the docks forever. I'm worried about that happening over in Guam. If we get them into Guam, the base is only at two right now. So it's going to be even worse trying to get fuel down on this place. We can build it up, but it's going to take time. And it's going to be damaged for a little while. So I think that the three tankers we're sending over to Wake and then to Guam, they're just really going to gum up the works. Really, really, we're going to. The dry goods can at least we can get off, but the tankers need a port. So the three I'm sending over to Wake, that's it. I don't think I'll send any more than that. So a second convoy is going to drop into Wake, headed for Guam. Problem is, we've got these four tankers here. These tankers, remember, I may be stupid, but okay, I am stupid. Remember, I do remember the problems we had trying to unload. We'll get these. Oh, we'll get two of these tankers out at least. This one's not full. And this one's not full either. So we're going to continue loading these two tankers. But I do remember all the problems suffered over at Panape. Yes, I know. I may be stupid, but I do have a memory. So putting tankers, these major tankers, into Guam, which is probably going to be damaged for a while, may not be the best idea. It'll just be a plug. So there's two tankers here and another one here, heading for Wake, and then Guam. I could sure use the supplies, the fuel on there, but I think that might be the limit of the number of the tankers I can send to Wake. So I'll have to keep that in mind in the future. Ah, now we're over at Panape. Ah, enemy. Whoa, tanker. This tanker? Really? Is it a tanker or could it be a carrier misidentified as a tanker? I believe in earlier in the war, we were misidentifying some tankers down here, carriers as tankers. And this could be. So we're going on red alert at Ponape. Get all the fighters into their defensive positions. We've got fighter. Yep, get them out of training. Get them up on combat air patrol. I will take back something. I learned something the other, well, it's been recent. I said yesterday that when you name a group, you can't any group you rename, for example, this amphibious group, this is Guam Assault Lead. You can't see it in the listing. You can't see it if you call up the group of the list of task forces. Nope. Nothing here. So I had said you have to click on every damn task force in order to find out what it's named. And I'm wrong here. This was changed. I don't know when it was added, but it was added. If you mouse over, you can actually see the name. Now, this. It's not the greatest thing in the world. Of course, I'd like to be able to bring it up on the other menus, but at least you don't have to click on every damn task force to find out. So this is another. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. It's just that when they put it in, it's kind of a half measure when they put it in. Why not put it in for all so you can see it at any place rather than I have to go all the way across, I have to move over here, check on this, you know, I've actually got to move the damn mouse, sweeping it back and forth, back and forth, back and forth to find the task forces in order to find it. But at least, if I hold it over now, I get some information that I never had before. So there's Guam support, there's Assault 2, 3, 4, 5, all everything here. At least we have that much information. So I don't have to. Saves me one click or a few clicks. Okay, so Panate, we're going into battle stations mode. We're going to. All inbound convoys are canceled. Get out. Retreat to Roy Namur. Wait until we clarify exactly what the hell's going on here. We're making our move up here. The battles. Who flies? Good grief. Who's still flying the F4F 3 Alphas and the 3s, huh? Especially when we have a number of 4s available. Of course, me being sloppy, I didn't realize it. Combat Air Group. It was it Lexington? No. It was Yorktown. That's right. Yorktown. I was too dumb to realize I should have upgraded. Didn't. Sloppy. So we're flying these older fighters, even when we've got 170 more modern fighters. But we're stuck with it right now. And judging from the battles, we shot down 66 enemy aircraft. Not all of them in Saipan, but some of them here. And we lost 15. That's it. That ain't good. This is our first approach of a major. This is a major enemy stronghold. And we're not fighting very well. I'm just glad that if we hadn't sunk those Kido Butai carriers, we could be in some real trouble now. My guys just aren't fighting well. Still, with what choice do we have? Go forward. At Panape, we have three task forces unloading right now. We're going to disband them into the base. A little bit more protection, I think. Maybe not. At least now he's going to require a port attack if this is a carrier group. Two groups coming back. One's an AO. We're pulling out. But this one's got three destroyers. I'm going to send them onwards. I'm even going to give them a maximum reaction of 6. Maybe we'll intercept a carrier group. I don't know. We've got destroyers here. I'm going to form up another surface action group. These are very short range. These are the little Dutch destroyers. Not the mine layers. We'll have a reaction group of 6. Also, we'll put a patrol zone right on top. Right on top where our combat air patrols can protect us. We may as well keep it as a full refuel point. While the ships are in dock, we're going to try to repair a couple of them. Oh boy, these are ugly. Ugly repairs. But we're keeping them at readiness so that we can sail at any time. I don't want to put them into... except this one. I'll put them in a repair ship because I have to. The Livingston? No, we can repair normally. So Colton needs a. Let's see, Colton. It's unloaded, so that's fine. We have aircraft up. Okay, let's get them on to escort, 100%. Onto combat air patrol, 100%. We're going to fly them at 5 and 10,000. I've got the Warhawks. These guys. Well, we're going to grab a couple more replacements. I think we'll do naval search. Let's go up to 80%. What's the maximum range here? 25? Let's just go. I think 10 should be enough. Yeah, this is only 9 away, so 10 should be fine. We've got Warhawks flying at range 5. Drop them back to 100% at range 0. These guys are good up to, oh no, they're only at good up to 15,000. Okay, we'll fly one flight at 15,000. This other one, we'll keep them down at 5. Other long range, bring them back 0. This is base defense right now. I don't know if he's raiding or doing something else. I'm going to bring. Okay, now's your chance. Let's see. Dive bombers. Ooh, we're leaving in March. Okay, pilots wise. Pretty decent pilots. Transfer to Ponape. I'm going to search at 10%, range of 7. How many squadrons have we got here? We've got 7 of 8, so I can get another squadron up. Okay, this one's also leaving. I'll take this one instead. Pilots, decent pilots. Transfer Ponape. Let's get 10% in the air. Now, if they're going to fly them, we got to get them, got to give them some escort. If they're going to fly it, you got to give them escort. So I'm going to take these guys using drop tanks. We're going to go up to 9. Okay. Full squadron. We've got tons of. Okay, both are going to go to escort up to maximum 9. We owe it to them. We owe it to them. Carrier group heading in. No need to reorganize yet. Man, that was just one base. One base managed to get all that trouble and shoot down all my planes. How many did we lose? Let's take a look. Losses for the day. Today. Where was it? Today. Whoa! 19 Wildcats! Good grief! And this guy's flying from long range. Actually, 24 Wildcats overall. Good grief! These guys are terrible. And we haven't even gotten into strike range yet. All right. Had a little recording difficulty there, so I might have repeated some stuff. Apologies. I hope I didn't repeat too much. S-47 fires two torpedoes at a patrol boat, misses, and gets hit in return. Well. Oh! Two torpedoes fired at a destroyer escort. We return fire, hit it 9 times. Let's see. Loses contact, out of ammo. Did we kill the damn thing? Who knows? I don't know, if we hit it with Hedgehog, it could be dead. Anshan under air attack, Knight, no defense. Bombed twice. The runways are hit. Poji fires torpedoes and hits a transport. Drum decides not to fire, evades the sub chaser. Attack from Tinian. Well, 200, 300, over 350, 340. No, that's what. 330, 300, yeah, almost 350 Wildcats in the air. The enemy is decimated. Judies, over half the Judies. and one Tony, and most of the Tonys. No, not most, but none of the zeros. Interesting. Air attack on the carriers. Well, that's going to be managed. He managed to fight through all that aircraft. Wow. Wow. Maybe we don't have enough at high altitude. We have some. Maybe I need more at high altitude. Val's attack. 9 destroyed out of 16. That's going to drop the morale significantly. Another attack. More Val's and Kate's combined. Enterprise hit once. Air attack. Nix. 2 destroyed. Air attack. Tinian. 4 dive bomb. What? The Sonyas? These are land-based short-range dive bombers. What the hell are they doing out here? The dive bombers from Ponape attack. He had a transport, Kirikawa. Where the hell is he going? A loaded transport, even. Air attack. Whoa. Looks like he's coming from a ship here, so there's a carrier here, too. Air attack on the near Saipan. He's defending. We've got 101 Dauntlesses and dive bombers up. 1-0 destroyed. Several bombers destroyed. Oh! Carrier hit. Hyo is hit and sunk. Destroyers, Chiyoda. Whoa, we took a lot of losses. Where the hell are my escorts? Division. Bombed near Akyab. This is the Akyab bombing practice. Air attack from Tinian. Oh, pardon me, from Saipan. Warhawks are up. 4 enemy fighters destroyed, but we also lose 3. What the devil? Those 3 Alpha Zeros are doing really well. Must be they're upgraded. Air attack on Nakhon Sitamon. Sitamarat. Oh, we go back. Air attack on the air groups. Where are my escorts? Jaluit bombing practice. Air attack on a minesweeper near Guam. Sunk. Is that all it was? Just one lousy little coastal minesweeper? Bombardment Fusin. Near Fusin. Deliberate attack Mergui. 18-1 odds. Heavy Japanese casualties. Modest. Another loss. Damn it. 2 more vehicles destroyed. Bombardment near Chaifeng. Slow him down, comrades. Slow him down. Deliberate attack. Shock attack near Fusin, 638-1. Man, that's destroyed, but we also took losses. Obliterated.